Hi, on the next episode of DevOps Lab, join us as April Edwards shows us how to use Terraform in your pipelines. Welcome to the DevOps Lab. Today, we are joined by a very special guest, April Edwards, again. How are you doing, April?
Awesome, Abel. Great to be back.
Yeah, so recently we've been talking a lot about Terraform, right?
We have.
And you've even shown me some really cool stuff that we can do with Terraform. All good. All through the command line, which again, I love. Mm-hmm. But at some point, I'm going to want to make this a real-world type of application with a real-world type of pipeline.
Yeah.
Which means, is there a way for me to shoehorn all of this Terraform goodness into my pipeline so that I can provision my infrastructure through my pipelines using Terraform?
Yes, we can. Funny you should ask.
I know. Hysterical. I wonder how I knew I should ask that.
Azure DevOps, might you ask about. So yes, we can do this in Azure DevOps.
Okay.
So the reason why I say Azure DevOps is we want multi-cloud. Any
sure.
platform, any code,
sure.
right? That's what we boast in Azure DevOps, and we can prove it.
Mm-hmm.
So we can deploy on-prem, mm-hmm. we can deploy to the other clouds, and we can deploy to Microsoft Azure with ease.
Yes.
Definitely.
So everything in a pipeline starts from the build, mm-hmm. right? I check in code, that's going to kick off a build.
Yes.
So is that the same thing with Terraform?
Yes, it does. In fact, I'll show you what I have already pre-built for us. Okay?
Okay, perfect.
So my code is actually sitting in an Azure repo Git.
Okay.
Just by default, again, you can call from GitHub or Bitbucket, but I've just put in the Azure repo Git for kind of ease today. So what we're building is a web app in Azure. Okay.
It looks like a .NET Core application?
Correct, it is.
Okay.
So our first agent job is running the build of our .NET Core application, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then what it's doing is it's copying all those files to an artifact mm-hmm. and publishing that so for we can then go into release. So we make changes to our code, it will kick off the build cycle,
mm-hmm.
right? And we have our continuous integration done.
Yes.
And then it'll kick off continuous deployment and then deploy into our other environments.
Okay. So just to be sure, right? Mm-hmm. In our Git repo, we've got the source code for our .NET Core application. Mm-hmm. We also have all the Terraform files as well, as infrastructure as code.
Yes, right. So with those same that same main.tf file,
mm-hmm.
Those variable files are all in there. Yes, so we can go into our source code, just upload it. Again, we can upload to GitHub, right?
Mm-hmm.
Connect into Azure DevOps and say, right, I want to change something in my application, and it kicks off the build with our main file.
Excellent. Now, looking through your pipeline, it looks like what it's saying right now is it's going to go ahead and create for me my .NET Core application, mm-hmm. create the binaries for me, and then we're going to use that as our build artifact. It's also copying the Terraform file. So then as part of the build artifacts, I've got my web code, my web binaries,
mm-hmm.
but it will also copy my Terraform files for me as well.
Yes, it will.
So
it
now
does.
It's ready to be consumed by our release pipeline.
Right. So before, when I did everything manually, I went into PowerShell and launched it. Now you can do Bash, you can do it from Azure Cloud Shell, you can do it wherever you want. That's
mm-hmm.
great. Well, what if we didn't have to type stuff in and, you know, remember the lines and do all that stuff? We have little pretty pictures here to execute that for us and automate it, right?
Fantastic.
And version control it, which is even more important.
Yep.
Right?
Yep. So it looks like if this build runs, it's going to build my web, it's going to grab my Terraform files, it's going to have them as build artifacts, it's ready for my release pipeline. Let's take a look at the release pipeline.
Sure, absolutely. So I've already ran a couple builds.
Mm-hmm.
So if I go into my release pipeline, you can see that I've done a couple releases already.
Mm-hmm.
Let's create another release, all
sure.
right? Because what you can see is I have three different environments.
Mm-hmm.
I have dev, test, and prod. Right?
Yeah.
And it shows the artifacts here. Now, I've already set mine to do the latest artifact,
mm-hmm.
But I have another version in here. I could call that previous version if I wanted to and release that.
Cool. Okay.
So that artifact drop has the Terraform main file in it and has all my .NET changes in it,
mm-hmm.
But I want to call the latest, and we can go, right, let's kick off a new release.
So hold on a second. If you chose, let's say, an earlier build, I'm
mm-hmm.
sorry, according to what I'm thinking is going to happen is when you start provisioning with Terraform, it's going to access the state file, and it's going to say, oh, your infrastructure, it needs to change because it needs to be the old infrastructure. So it will massage my infrastructure till it looks like the old infrastructure, then deploy the web app on there.
Yes, it will. It has to change that infrastructure first. So if I go into my release pipeline that I've created,
okay,
I'll show you exactly how I've done it.
Sure.
Now, let's go into the dev workload. Into the tasks. So on the agent job, that is on my web app. So first thing I've done is it's using Azure CLI to deploy our Azure resources. So what it's done, so we talked about, you know, securing our resources, right? And we need
mm-hmm.
that state file.
Yep.
It's going to go and create it as a storage account in our first step. So we're going to make sure our state file is in our storage account. It's going to check that it's there.
Cool, cool, cool. So that very first line of code, you're just saying, provision for me a storage account. And in this storage account, it's going to hold my Terraform state file.
Correct. So we have an inline script here. Mm-hmm. So I talked to you earlier about, you know, we can script the creation of this. We can also automate it in our release pipeline.
Yep.
So we put that in there. It creates the storage containers, creates the storage account, and the keys. So we talked about keys, right? Because we need
sure.
to secure this. So in the next step, it gets the keys mm-hmm. For that storage account.
Okay.
And puts them in as a variable in Azure DevOps.
Got
so
it.
we've instead of using Key Vault, we're using Azure DevOps to hold that variable.
Got it.
Okay. So again, so my organization will have access to deploy this,
mm-hmm.
but actually can't see the keys. I don't have to release the keys to anyone. It's secured, and it automates the whole thing, and no one has to go and like retrieve the keys every time, right?
Sure.
So yeah.
Okay.
So those are the first couple steps there.
Next up, you're mm-hmm. replacing your tokens, so I'm guessing now it's going to replace all the tokens that you need in your Terraform files.
Correct. Mm-hmm. It's going to replace those in for us, and then what it does, it's also running version 0.12.3 of Terraform.
Okay.
So the one thing we have to be careful of is when Terraform versions change, your code has to change.
Yes.
And so if you have to match what version you're calling here to the code you've written.
Yeah.
The other thing is to Azure DevOps may not support the latest code, so it's always really important to do the version that you know works with your code. That's
Got
step
it.
One.
Okay.
So if we can put in here like the latest version of Terraform, mm-hmm. but if your code in Terraform doesn't write to that, it will all fail. So write, you know, deploy to the latest version or the version that you're currently working to and coding
Got
to.
Got it. And these are the built-in tasks from Terraform?
Yes, these are. So all we need to do, so it's really simple. I go to run an agent job.
Mm-hmm.
We have this in our marketplace.
Okay.
Right? So I type in Terraform, and we have different Terraform modules that we can call.
Okay.
So these are all pre-built. We don't have to write anything. Makes it really easy to adopt Azure DevOps, right? Because we've written it in the marketplace for you.
Yep.
Yeah.
And then the next couple, this is just the same thing that you were doing before, right? The init, the plan.
Exactly that. And you know what? It's running through our initialize, our plan. And again, we have record and versioning of this now. And
yes.
that's the advantage of doing this in Azure DevOps. We can version what we're doing, and we have record of it. We have logging. We have all those great features built in. It's awesome. I love it.
Yep.
This gets me really excited because customers want to, you know, enable logging. They want to track. They want to use boards. Their project managers want to know what's going on. It's all right here in this tool, and we can integrate it with Terraform. And it's pretty seamless.
Yeah, and it looks really simple, too. Like, if I have my infrastructure as code written in Terraform, to put it into the pipeline, simple enough, right? And then you provision using Terraform. You just use your Terraform tasks.
Mm-hmm.
And then when that's done, you just deploy your application into the infrastructure however you would.
Exactly. So this is now going into my infrastructure. Now, mm-hmm. so the really cool thing about Terraform is, so before when we were authenticating to deploy code, we have to log into the portal. We have to find, there are different ways to authenticate, to allow authentication mm-hmm. Into our portal to deploy those Terraform bits of code. I've created a service principal from Azure DevOps
mm-hmm.
Into Azure. So when I go to log in and deploy this, I can actually choose what subscription I have access to.
Mm-hmm.
So I've already configured the service connection. I've already authorized it.
Sure.
So you can deploy into multiple subscriptions, but I know this one works. I've created the service principal, and it's a secure connection to our cloud.
Yes. Fantastic. This is really cool stuff. I had no idea it was this easy to use Terraform in your pipelines.
Yeah, absolutely. It's easy to build. You go to the marketplace, select it, put it in, and call your main file. There you go.
Yeah. Super, super simple.
Yes.
Thank you so much, April.
Thank you, Abel.
All right. So developers, again, if you're using Terraform, let's start sticking Terraform into our pipelines. Thank you all.